Hey, piggy people. So today I had two guinea pigs go to the vet that I wanted to update you on. One was Pecan and one was Reese. So we'll start off with Pecan. Just the other night when I was looking at her mouth, I noticed that her front incisors were slanted. So that could be a sign of tooth troubles because they should be, perfectly straight. So they were wearing on a bit of an angle. So she went to the vet today to get checked out. Now, without putting her out, they look in her mouth with this scope to look at her back molars. And my vet said, from what she could see, there was nothing alarming, nothing that looked overgrown with her molars. There was no red flags there. She classed her incisors as a slight slant. She said it didn't look anything too terribly concerning to her since they're wearing perfectly straight and it's not a case of one tooth is overgrowing the other. So she told me to just keep an eye on it. She said if it was a younger piggy, she would sedate her, well, put her under, so I guess anesthesia, and just do a little bit of trimming to make them even and see if they'd stay like that. She said for Pecan's age, since she's 7, she's a bit reluctant to go in and do that unless it's absolutely necessary. So she said, if it starts to get worse or you start to notice her having any troubles eating, then we'll have to go and get that done. So part of me was feeling like, okay, did I cause this by hand feeding her too much and stopping her from eating enough hay? So it's been about a week that I was hand feeding her extra because of that one morning where I found her flipped over on her back. And my vet said she'd find it really hard to believe that that was the cause. She said it can just happen gradually over time as they age, weaker jaw muscles, that type of thing. So it's kind of one of those things you don't really know. But just to be safe, I am going to cut back what I'm hand feeding her. I'm just going to stick with giving her a bit extra after I give her morning meds. And in the evening, I've decided to give her fresh grass with her medications. So I've done that 2 nights in a row now. I just pick some really long fresh grass and take her out of the cage. And after she's had her meds, she just eats as much fresh grass as she wants because thankfully it has not caused her any issues with bloat. So the fresh grass is going to be great for grinding her teeth. And I would love if we could fix the slant. So I'm going to have to just keep an eye on it. Luckily, she's eating fine and she has absolutely no problem packing away food. It was really good to see with the fresh grass. Like she's eating it super fast. She's not drooling. She's not like picking stuff up and dropping it. So I'm gonna keep an eye on that. So the next piggy that went to the vet is Reese, and I'm not sure where Reese is right at the moment. So Reese started having a wet bum. So she had signs of like a UTI, and I noticed that she had urine scald. So the one day I picked her up to check because her bum looked wet and it was soaked on her belly and she had scald kind of in her pubic region where actually like skin was kind of peeling off. I felt horrible. So as you guys know, Reese loves to lay down, so it's really hard to get a good look at her bum because she's always laying down. So I felt bad that I didn't notice sooner. So she got a bum bath and luckily the skin was already healing. And it didn't look bad, so she's on antibiotics now and some pain medications. And it happened 2 days in a row where she kept having a soaked butt, so that's why I was just like, okay, she needs some medication for this. Obviously, something's going on. And my vet told me that Reese's weight is up from the last time that she was there, so she said, Reese is too chubby. She said this could be a contributing factor to her getting scald just based off of her weight. So she would really like to see Reese lose a bit of weight. So that's a very rare thing to ever hear for a piggy, but I do agree, Reese is huge. And I think Reese is like my spirit animal for laying down and just eating her feelings. So she's a very lazy pig. If she can lay down while eating or drinking, she does. So if you need your guinea pig to lose weight because a medical professional told you to for medical reasons, there's a few things you can do. I want to emphasize never in your life do you cut back their hay. So they still get the same amount of hay. The things that you can safely cut back are pellets, some veggies. You could even cut back fruits and treats. So in Reese's case, like, I don't feed any treats. I don't feed any fruits. I don't feed very much in the way of vegetables. So pellets is the only thing that I think is the big contributing factor to her weight. So in a herd, it is so difficult to monitor how much every pig gets because they like to kind of just eat pellets randomly here and there. And I like to have pellets out at all times so that Pecan can have some and Apple. So Pecan doesn't get any vegetables, so her source of nutrition really does come from the pellets. And Apple, with her kidney issues, I want her to have access to the pellets. So the solution I have come up with in my mind is, as you guys know, Pecan and Apple at night get blocked off from the other guys. Since Pecan, I found her flipped upside down one night. So now to keep her safe, she stays with Apple in one section during the night. So I think during the night, I will take the pellets away from the four pigs and I'll keep pellets in with Apple and Pecan. And then during the day, I will give the herd their pellets back. And I'm going to have to put less in the dish. And if they run out with that quantity, they run out kind of thing. So I am going to have to take it seriously because getting urine scald and getting a UTI from getting a messy bum due to being overweight is not fun. So I'm going to try that and I will keep track of her weight and see how that goes. I think that should make a fairly big difference if she's having like a very decent amount of time with no pellets and I'm portioning them out smaller.
Hi, how are you? You're so adorable. No, we're not doing any extra foods. You gotta eat your hay.
So, yeah, so anybody who wants to know, Reese weighs 1,400 grams. That's how much she weighed today. So she's about, I think, like 100 grams more than the last time she was at the vet. So, like, that's really huge. To put that in perspective, Huckle weighs 1,200, and like Apple weighs 900, Raisin weighs about 1,000, the skinny pig sisters weigh about 850, so I mean, 1,400 is large, and I knew she was large. It's just one of those things that, like, what are you supposed to do? Like, it's so difficult having them in a herd to make sure she's not overeating on the pellets. And my husband was laughing, saying that she needs to go for a jog and that I got to take her outside for walks and stuff like that. And, like, the thing is, if I take her out of the cage for floor time, she doesn't move. She just sits there and eats. So I think the pellets is the only thing I can think of to cut back and hope that that helps her. So, yeah, that's kind of where we're at. I just feel like it's never ending, the things that are going on around here. So anyway, we just cleaned everybody out. So everything is nice and fresh and clean, which I always love. Here's the little skinny pig sisters. The little tiny ladies who eat and eat and eat and eat and eat and eat. Like, they eat way more than Reese and they still stay the same. But that's skinny pigs for you. They have super fast metabolisms, and I think Reese has my metabolism, very slow. And then over here is Angus and Autumn. Oh, look at Autumn. She's all snuggled in a little cuddle cup. And here's Mr. Angus, who just hid from us. Hi, Bubby. You're so cute. What an adorable little man. So anyway, I've got a fat piggy, but who doesn't? And I just want you guys to know that guinea pigs weigh all different weights and are all different sizes. It's just more common for boars to be the size that Reese is. And I know other people might have pigs who could weigh the same as Reese who aren't classed as fat, but for Reese's body shape and size, she is too fat, I guess. Tubbies, why are you frozen? She's staring at me like she...
If you like watching guinea pig videos, learning how to care for us, seeing product hauls or reviews, or really anything else, guinea pig, please subscribe and make sure you hit that notification bell so you never miss a video. Down below, I've left two more videos for you to pick from, so keep on watching.